स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल बी स्टडिंग अबाउट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ मेल गैमेटोफाइट। द मेल गैमेटोफाइट इन द केस ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स इज द पोलन ग्रेन। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी हाउ पोलन ग्रेन्स आर डेवलप्ड और फॉर्म्ड। वी नो दैट देर आर माइक्रोस्पोरोफिल which is the male reproductive structure, and in the microsporophyll there are microsporangia or the pollen sac. This we have seen during the TS of anther. We go through the diagram of TS of anther. There you will be able to see the diathecous anther which we have discussed earlier, and then in the diathecous anther we have seen the four microsporangia. Inside the microsporangia, if I just draw the microsporangia, this is the microsporangia. One microsporangia we have drawn. Suppose this is microsporangia. Microsporangia. So inside the microsporangia, there are sporogenous tissues, which are compactly arranged when the anther is immature. They are also known by the name archisporial cells. And there is a layer which is surrounding this microsporangia, which is called as the tapetum, made up of the pyramidal cells. Now, as the anther develops, the sporogenous tissue, they become loosely arranged. So if we take one sporogenous tissue out, this is a diploid cell, and it is also called as MMC or the microspore mother cell, and it will go under reductional division meiosis, and this will result into the formation of a tetrad, which we have discussed earlier. So this is a tetrad which I am drawing here. This tetrad, you know by which name? If you can recall the name of this tetrad, it is called as the tetrahedral structure of the tetrad, because it is the most common one, so we have drawn it. Afterwards, the four cells, three are visible here, one will be on the backward side. They will get separated and they will form four microspores. These microspores are formed. Microspores are formed. And these all microspores are haploid structures. These microspores are now going to get developed into this pollen grain, which is the gametophyte. Why it is called gametophyte? Because it contains the male gamete. So when we draw the developmental stages of the male gametophyte, what we find here? Now we start with a functional microspore, a haploid cell. This is a microspore. Now this microspore will have a haploid content of the chromosomes, and it will be surrounded by a layer which is called as the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane. Now the tapetum will be responsible for synthesizing two protective coverings. The first covering which develops around it is made up of cellulose and pectin. And this layer, which we have drawn here, is known as the intine. Surrounding the intine, one more layer is being formed. And this layer is even from inside and uneven from outside. So the even layer I have drawn this time, the uneven layer will be on the outer side like this. This is the uneven surface. And this one more layer which is forming around this microspore by the tapetal layer is called as the exine. This is exine layer. And this is most important layer because it contains a non-degradable material which is called as the sporopollenin. Which is not degraded by acid, base or any enzyme, etc. This layer is a discontinuous layer, as you can see some spaces left. These left spaces are called as the germ pore or germ furrow. Germ pore, which is also called by a name germ furrow also, and this is responsible for the development of the pollen tube. Now, once this structure is formed, this will become a pollen grain. Now it will be called as a pollen grain with a haploid content of chromosome. This pollen grain will go under mitosis. And when it will go under mitosis, the inner content of the cell will get divided into two parts. First by karyokinesis and then by cytokinesis. So when there will be karyokinesis, there will be divided two nuclei. And the cytoplasmic division, that is the cytokinesis, is an equational type of division in which a small generative cell and a big vegetative cell is formed. So this bigger cell which is formed is the vegetative cell, also known by a name the tube cell, or the nucleus of this cell is called as the tube nucleus, and this smaller cell is called as the generative cell. This one is called as vegetative because it is not going to involve in the process of reproduction. It is not going to form the reproductive cells. It is just responsible for the formation of pollen tube. This stage which is formed here is called as the two-celled stage. The two-celled stage of the pollen grain. And in majority of the angiosperms, more than 60% of the angiosperms, they develop the pollen grain in the two-celled stage itself. And the pollen grains which are released from the anther after the process of dehiscence, when the wall layers are becoming fibrous and at the point of stomium, the wall gets broken down and the developed pollen grains in two-celled stage gets released. But this is in majority of 60% angiospermic plants. Remaining 40% plants, they release their pollen grains in three-celled stage. And how? After the two-cell is formed, the generative cell goes under one more mitotic division and it will form two cells inside it. So there are now three cells, vegetative cell and two other cells which are called as the two male gametes. And this stage is being forming in the 40% of angiosperms, which is called as the three-celled stage of the pollen grain. This is how the pollen grains or the male gametophyte is formed in the angiospermic plants. This is all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.